Ideas. A lot of guys take girls to the wrong places on first dates, so I'm gonna help my brothers out. Feel free to steal any of these ideas. I came up with this idea because I made the mistake of taking a girl to Movies 8, which is the dollar theater, on our first date. And people think Movies 8 is only a dollar because they're like older movies. No, it's only a dollar because you're probably gonna get stabbed while you're there. But I took a girl to Movies 8. And it was going pretty well. We were watching the movie, but then she tried that whole trick where she cuts a hole in the bottom of the popcorn tub, and then she puts it over her breast. So I reach in and accidentally fondle her breast. But in the process, she spilled $18 with my popcorn all over the floor. So instead of fondling her breast, I cut her breast off and wore it as a hat for the rest of Avatar. So don't do that. Instead, here's a few good first date ideas. Wendy's in a limo, King Hummers, Church on Mushrooms, Teddy Bear Factory where they make teddy bear, jujitsu class, your racist uncle's house, Martin Luther King rally, graffiti museum at 516 Arts, downtown to my plaza, you not included. By plaza, I meant loft just now. A stand-up comedy show at Tureen Hookah Lounge. Cow tipping, his breaking the windows of Hummers. Crashing the tires of Hummers. Cop tipping. One up bar and grill. Joe's next door is a pretty good place. Mini golf, strip mini golf, strip dictionary. Pretty much strip anything. Tureen Hookah Lounge during the week because hookahs are $2 cheaper. A meadow on a tire swing in the meadow, overlooking the hills while the sun sets and the stars delicately paint a flush yellow tone on her cheeks, and the blue jays sing unwritten songs of love for you and her. And you wrap your arms around her and pull her in close to your chest, and she bites her lip and looks down smiling. And she knows she's never felt these feelings that she's feeling now, but she hopes she will continue to feel these feelings for years and years to come. And a breeze blows some grass across her face, and she thinks it's your whisper, but it's not. It's just some grass. So when you whisper into her ear, she gets super erotically turned on. And you guys sit there, just holding each other, wanting more and more love as the night goes, not even thinking about sex, but not even realizing that you are hard as a rock. You pat her shoulders, and she looks up at you, her eyes bubbling, just the pregnancy glow, even though she's not pregnant. And you whisper, I love you, but you don't even have to say it, because she knows you love her, and you know she loves you right back. Mexican buffet.